If you're like me, you've probably burned through dozens of one-off scripts to generate mock data streams so that you can work on some real-time data project. Mock data is important. We need it to be able to test and validate the things that we've built. But it can be pretty hard to come by, especially when we need mock data streams and not just some sample CSV. In this screencast, I'll show you how to generate mock data streams based on a JSON schema and stream them to the destination of your choice using Mockingbird, the mock data stream generator created by Tinybird. Mockingbird is a free, open source, headless library for generating mock data streams. Feel free to clone the repo in GitHub and get building. I've linked to that repo below. Now, it's also available as a CLI for the keyboard warriors, but in this screencast, I'm going to demonstrate the Mockingbird UI that Tinybird hosts on its own domain. And you can see that generating some mock data streams is a three-step process. You're going to connect to your desired streaming destination, you're going to build your data schema, and then you'll start generating mock data. Let's get into it. Okay, so the first step is to select and connect to your streaming destination. As of the time that I'm recording this screencast, there are two supported destinations, Tinybird Events API and the Upstash Kafka REST producer. Again, this is an open source library and it's relatively easy to add new destinations. So if there's one you want to see, feel free to add it. For this screencast, I'll show you how to generate mock data and stream it to the Tinybird Events API, which will then write that mock data into a Tinybird data source. And then at the end, we can see how to publish same APIs over that data using Tinybird. So you need to configure your Tinybird destination. First, you're going to need to select your Tinybird host, which in my case is the US GCP host. And then you need to name your data source. Now you can use an existing data source if you're using a pre-designed schema that matches that data source, but the Events API will also create a new data source automatically if the data source name that you provide does not yet exist. And next you need to provide a Tinybird token that has data source write permissions. So I'm going to go to my Tinybird workspace, grab my admin token, which has that permission, and then paste it here. And then you're going to want to define the event generation frequency and set a limit for the total number of events to generate if you don't want events to be created indefinitely during your session, and then click continue. Now the next step is to define your event data schema. You'll see that your schema will be configured in JSON, and there are several sample schemas that you can use as is or augment. You'll see that the schema basically consists of a column name, a data type, and then any parameters associated with that data type. Now, there are tons of data types to choose from, ranging from very basic data types like int, float, string, bool, to date times, to ranges, addresses, web data, random names, browsers, fake emails, and more. Under the hood, Mockingbird is using the JavaScript Faker library to generate random data for all these different data types. So you can also supply a list of values to choose from and even supply a weighting to those values as well. You can check out all the supported types in the Mockingbird docs, which are linked in the YouTube description below. And remember, this is an open source library. So if you need a data type that isn't currently supported, feel free to add it yourself or raise an issue in the GitHub repo, which is linked below, and we'll do our best to add it for you. So let's go ahead and start generating. You'll be greeted by an upward ticking counter of events being generated at the rate that you set and sent to your destination. Now, if we head back over to our Tinybird workspace, we'll see that data source that we created and the events streaming into it. And now, of course, since I'm in Tinybird, I can create a pipe to write some SQL to get, say, the percentage of sales that used a promo code in the last X minutes, which I'll define using the Tinybird templating language with a default value of 30 minutes. And then I can go up here and publish this SQL as an API in a click. And now as I call that API, as my mock data streams in, I can see that roughly 5% of the sales use a promo code, which makes sense, because in my schema, that column used weighted values with a 20-to-1 ratio. Mockingbird really is the simplest way to stream mock data. Go ahead and try it out, and if you feel so inclined, please contribute to the project. We're always looking to add new data types and new destinations. Thanks. See you later.